Any further movement on your turn? You said, alrighty. I'm going to circle around. I assume that's what you're going to do.
I mean, I've not been shouted anything otherwise. Thank you for that.
45 would be like here-ish, and then another... What? 70... 90 would be like here-ish. Right, you could probably get maybe to this door if you plan it a little bit better. I think that's 90 right there to avoid the pillar. Alright.
Got it.
You could see Kill in the hallway.
I'm just bounding around on all fours, skidding around the corner.
Are you seeing this shit?
Gigantic sword in your teeth.
Yeah.
Hey!
Bonus action? Are you good?
No, I don't have anything to bonus action.
Lucel!
Okay, doorway's still open. 5, 10, 15, 8, 15, 20, yep, 20. And, Sacred Flame again.
Sacred Flame! Dexterity save, 5! 7 full radiant damage will be taken by this creature.
And she goes, alright, this thing don't like the sun, don't like the holy light, woo! And she backs up another 5 feet, so that's 25. 30.
Alrighty, Sheree! You do have to come a little bit back closer. Sorry.
I can tolerate that, considering I'm not getting fucking destroyed.
I can't wait till you back up into another encounter.
Jesus.
9 is not gonna do it. The rolls, guys. Even your characters are tired. Holy shit.
Thank this way.
Christ.
I keep rolling shit from our radiant damage, too, man.
The shimmy shimmy back and forth. Alright, is that you, Sheree?
Yep.
Alright, we'll get Panaziver to fire a pair of hand crossbows. An 11 is going to miss, but a 15 will hit for 5. And she's going to continue to kite backwards with Zashi.
Hey, Nate, are these columns?
Yes, but there's not. Like, I didn't do them on the dynamic plating.
Yeah, no, that's okay. I mean, if they give at least partial cover, right? Because the angle, that would help.
To ranged attacks, yes.
Yeah, but not for the breath weapon, yeah.
Cutlass, Mr. Kill.
Right. So, is it just the slime in the room? Is anybody else looking at this thing? Is it? It's fighting something else?
You can only see what you can see. You don't think any one of your friends are in the room, but you can't see the whole room. You can, if you look to your west, see Zeke, who's come around the corner over there.
I see Zeke. Okay, okay. I would like to move back into the room.
And dangerous.
It is very dangerous, but it needs to die.
Alrighty.
I've been feeling a little lucky, so let's see. Back into the room.
Well, he does have rakish audacity.
Rakish audacity, that is true.
Huh? So you step into the room, short sword in one hand, dagger in the other.
Right, so it's just me in this room right now. Zeke is all the way at the end of the hallway, everyone else is in the other room.
Yeah, it's just
into a door.
Line. Yep.
Alright, what can I do? What was the condition for the sneak attack? It has to be either me and somebody else. Even looking at somebody else.
You don't have to click the gear to open the stuff on your sheet. You can just click on the word, the name. That way it's easier to read. Also, but for the features for sneak attack are, if you don't have, if you have advantage and don't have disadvantage, or if a friend is in there. And if you have fancy footwork, or I'm sorry, rakish audacity, you gain an additional way to use your sneak attack. You don't need advantage if you're within 5 feet of the creature and no other creatures are within 5 feet of you, and you don't have disadvantage. So that's right now.
Alright, so I can use my rakish audacity to be able to sneak attack.
Yes.
Alright, I would like to do that then.
Check that on and make a short sword and a dagger attack. You only get the sneak attack once in a turn, but you have two opportunities to try and get it.
Okay, so short sword right now, boom.
21's definitely gonna hit. Give me that sneak attack. That sexy sneak attack.
And then press the short sword, right?
Uh-huh.
For
17 damage. Very nice. You nearly bloody this thing. It has this large central tendril that you almost sever off, and quite a bit of gel comes gushing out, but not as much as the first time you stabbed the other one. You can still do your dagger attack. You will not get sneak attack again, but you can do it for a little bit extra damage. Try to push it over that bloody edge.
So let's push it over the edge. Where's the dagger?
Probably right. Alright,
dagger. Dagger.
17's gonna hit. Very nice. Consistent damage. Okay, so 7, so that is gonna be 4 from the dagger. Which will bloody this thing. You puncture it and that expected huge gush of ooze comes splashing out. You still have 20 feet of movement left, and you have fancy footwork, so it can attack you. What do you want to do?
Cool. I'm going to move back. I'm just going to, like, move back into the hallway.
Sure.
Like, 20 feet of movement. Style. Like, I just tagged him up like Jerry, and then I just ran back into my hole.
Hell yeah.
Go back into the hole.
All right. Is that you?
That's me right there.
All righty. A squelch. A squish. This thing is coming in your direction.
Uh-oh.
Let's see how pissed off it is. Not quite that pissed off, but it is upset as it reaches down the tunnel with pseudopods.
Oh, shit.
A 10 and a 16. A 16 is going to hit.
Ah, oh, fuck. All right.
You need to take 9 bludgeoning and 14 acid. 23 total. You are also grappled.
23. Jesus. Alright. That hurts.
I bet. We'll go to Zashi while you figure out your damage.
Minus 23, right?
Right in that little blue bubble. Boom.
Bonus action moving my mind guy.
Cool.
Ow.
Now I see. I see it. Through my mind's eye. I'm gonna cast Witch Bolt again, but I'm level 3.
Alright. 18's gonna hit.
Hey V, if you use was it when you have 3 proficiency count, I think with the Manifest Mind, you can actually use one of those proficiency counts. You have, I think you have 3 right now. To cast the spell from the Manifest Mind too.
She just did.
That's what I did.
Did.
That's,
okay.
That's literally what she just did.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch that.
That hits, 18 hits.
Yeah.
I thought she was casting from herself. My bad.
Apologies for the delay. My laptop is giving me trouble.
Pardon my confusion.
If you want, you can just type /3d12.
Ooh,
excellent.
Nice.
18 damage. It is resistant to elemental damage. Lightning is included, so that is 9. But every little bit counts as you crackle out from the tiny version of Zashi, and it sets this thing a crackle with lightning damage. Thankfully, it doesn't transfer up the pseudopod to kill. Is that your turn, Zashi?
Yes.
Huh?
Kill it, please! Also, no reactions for it.
Also, no reactions for it, because of Witch Bolt. Wait, or is that...
I'm sorry, no,
that,
sorry,
that's... Shocking Grasp.
My brain fucking
yeah.
Mixed up the two, sorry.
It should... I wish they did more stuff like that, like all cold magic slowed you, and all lightning damage removes your reaction. Like, it would help unify specific elemental class play more, I think. It would encourage it. Anyway, Zeke.
Alrighty, I'm still pretty fucking far away.
Long tunnel.
But I can get... I'll get to here. And then, running leap, sword still in mouth, whip out a javelin and throw.
Throw it.
Times
16's gonna hit. 17 will definitely hit in that case. 5 and 4 for 9 piercing damage. Heave out 2 giant javelins that fly over Kill's head as he's struggling to break out of the pseudopod.
I'll do my best, but if I can, you got any less requests.
Can't hear me.
Lucel, if that's you, Zeke. Oh,
yeah, I'm just into the room.
Smart. Lucel! It's you!
Ten. 15, 20, 25, 30. I can't see it. Yeah, I can't see it. Well, she is flying. Do I remember how Isis can perceive the world or no?
With a 13, you know they have blind sight.
Okay, but
they don't have eyes.
They don't have eyes, though. Oh. Let's see here. Double move. So 5, 10, 15, 20.
I would just say, I will point out there is a difference between tremor sense and blind sight.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh yeah, so distance, yeah. Yeah, she's gonna stop there.
Okay.
And unfortunately she's got nothing else left right now she can do, so that's it.
Shabri!
But she is airborne too, so.
Okay.
I'm taking the dodge action because I have no clue where the fuck anyone else is.
Okay. You're good where you are. Penazivra will roll her eyes, give Zashi a pat on the shoulder, and come jogging past. Bonus action to dash into the room. She'll pull up short and fire a pair of... You know what? No, yeah, she's gonna pull up short. She was pretty hurt in that other fight. And fire a pair of crossbow bolts. For 18 damage, which is 4 more than we needed. Kill, as you're struggling to pull this thing off of you, it suddenly goes limp and then turns into like almost uncontained liquid, popping like a water balloon of acid, and sprays down the front of you before quickly dropping to the floor and beginning to dissolve. And you guys are, for the moment, out of combat.
Jesus Christ. That was the most disgusting shit I've ever... I'm never eating Jell-O ever again.
You lose me? Buddy, if that's all you've seen, you ain't seen none.
That was disgusting.
And then I'll pick up my javelins from the corpse.
Yeah. Thankfully, this is they're not corroded or anything. None of your weapons suffered any damage. You guys are the ones that were being burned by acid, not the other way
around. Just sort of, like, edge my way around it. Hey, Sparks, you, got any idea whether we could sell this shit? Because...
I don't think anybody's gonna want this.
Alright.
She'll, like, look Zeke over and raise her, like, fiery eyebrows, like, you okay?
I'm a little hurt.
Yeah, can we, you know...
I think we should
take a break,
hunker down, and
wait,
yeah. I got nothing besides my cantrips now.
Take 5.
Penazivra points back.
They hurt me.
Penazivra points up towards Shuri.
I feel like we should...
I mean, potentially even a full night. I'm kind of tapped. I don't know about the rest of y'all.
Okay, well, I guess we could go back in the room I just came out of, because that's a bit easier to defend, I guess. It's not so tight quarters. And there's some pillars you can use, potentially.
There are two doors in this room. We know what's on one side, and we know what's on the other.
I have a question. Is there anything on these slime things? Is that it? They just dissolved into nothing knows it?
Not nothing. They're basically steaming piles of
acid.
Blood. If you want to... make me a nature or an arcana check to know about what's happening, you can absolutely do so. But as you watch them dissolve, the things that are left are basically like puddles of congealed blood, for lack of a better word. Not quite like a scab, but more like an embolism but the size of a small, the size of a softball.
Partially coagulated.
Yeah, just like a mass of thick, wet blood. It's not meat, it's just blood. It looks like it was like curdled blood. Imagine, you know, how it thickens and clicks and becomes chunky. Well, the blood pudding isn't chunky. It's
not chunky. It's just like
it's chunky. If it's bad,
it could be.
The blood pudding I've had is chunky.
This I'm good off the bad blood pudding. Yeah, I'm good off of the bad blood pudding. I'm just gonna close the door behind me.
Sure.
Hey, Twiggy, which of these doors was the way back? I kind of got whacked, so.
Probably never closed it, so it should be further.
Click, click.
You good back there, Zip?
She gives a thumbs up, but she unlocks the door and walks over. She points at this door again. Click, click. And opens the room that you guys found where you took your first short rest.
Yeah. Hey, Twiggy, this way.
Nice.
As ever, we'll wave to everybody. Oh, where are you going, Zashi?
Away! Away!
Your mind.
I've got 300 feet on her. She can go wherever she wants.
Lose your head if it wasn't attached.
Real quick, I'm just gonna.
Lucille flies over to the bed, to the piles of, or the. Sleeping bags that are on the ground. She immediately starts casting prestidigitation on one, and then hides inside of it.
Wow, we don't even have to set up camp.
What do you reckon your chances of locking some of these doors behind us are?
She kind of holds up her hand and gives a side-to-side motion. Maybe.
Yeah. You want to give it a go?
She'll walk over. I guess she'll still roll sleight of hand to relock it. 15 does not meet the DC that I had set to unlock these doors, so I'm going to say that it also doesn't lock them. She'll try on the other side before giving up, but these are DC 16 locks. Actually, first she'll open this one. And then she'll come over to this one and try and lock this one first. 9 is not going to do it.
The CLCs are struggling and casts giggles and says, "You got this, honey," and gives her inspiration.
Okay, so D8.
D6, I think, still.
Really? At level 7?
For level... Well, no, it's level 1 bard.
It's about bard. Yeah. 14 plus 4 is 18. Locks this one. You now have 2 locked doors.
And then which door wasn't? So this door in the bottom and the door in the dark on the right, that one is locked on the left?
Yes, you should be able to see which ones are locked.
Okay. I guess Pensifer tells that to everybody else. And so Lucille looks down at this wheelbarrow and says, like, "Hey, Captain, maybe we could take some of this furniture and just use it to bar the door? Or at least create a small obstacle?"
Yeah, not a bad idea.
Okay, you're a bit stronger than I am, so maybe... I mean, I can help, and she goes and starts taking some things. Bring it over.
This cart and fill it up with boxes and shit and bring it over to the door to pile up. Yeah.
Lucille comes over with one small box of heavy.
Oh, here we go.
For her, and just slops it over on top.
Your old friend, the animated table.
The guy.
Oh, no. What is that?
Round 3. No
revenge.
Oh shit, it's a table.
No, that thing hurt, man. The entire fucking house of animated furniture. It was miserable.
Mm-hmm. It was awesome. You guys loved it.
It's true, we did. What the fuck? But just describing it to kill it would be like, I was fucking miserable. Everything is trying to kill you. The closet. They all chased the fucking hag. I had to kill all the furniture.
After a few moments, all of a sudden Zashi and runs over to. Is this door now locked? Which door is now locked?
This door is not locked.
Okay. Just runs over and goes and opens the door.
It is. You cannot. Zeke and Fenizer have just spent 10 minutes blockading it with wood and.
Ah!
Table.
Zashi in character would not have known that because they were experiencing only the senses of their mind. As they come back, they look over, and the door that they want to open is completely barred with multiple boxes and tables.
She, like, eyes roll back into her head again.
Collapses to the floor, boneless.
Boneless.
Boneless wizard for dinner.
Boneless wizard.
Lucille goes over to Zashi.
My mind is stuck outside.
Oh, you can just miss that spell.
I know, but I don't really want to. Oh, I mean, it's going to go away anyways, though. Because I'm going to...
Help, mother, let me in.
I can recast it, I guess. Yeah, so, yeah. I wanted to snoop around a little bit. But I've seen all that I can see. There's nothing... No popped up or anything like that, so...
Hey, Zashi.
Zashi's eyes unroll and she looks up. Sorry. I'm in my mind thingy.
Oh,
it's
do you want
right
me
outside
you
that door. Points to the door.
Oh, I can't help you there. I'm too small. You saw my arms are itty bitty. I can't lift that stuff. But I can, I guess, like either make myself bigger and carry you to a sleeping bag if you want.
No, I'm good. I can carry myself.
Okay. Also, hey, do you have any good rituals in your book? I can actually copy them down if that's cool to you.
She's a little cagey about her book. She kind of shiftily, like, looks down and is like, let me take a look. Goes and lays down. Oh, and I guess I dismiss the mind thing. It feels like metagaming, but it's not.
Lucille would actually fly over, clean another one of the sleep bags, and get comfy in that while watching Zashi with very big, bright fairy eyes.
Not creepy at all.
Jesus.
Little Perito with the big eyes poking off the inside.
Kill picks one of these chairs to sit in and have a nap.
How do I know if something's a ritual?
It'll say there'll be a small R near where it like has the little C where for the concentration. Have like a little R at the top. It will also say tell you in the description if it's a ritual. I don't think you have a single ritual spell.
No, I do not.
No detect magic, speak with animals.
Nope.
Sorry.
Nope.
No comprehension.
It's my first wizard.
Nope. It's okay. Yeah, Lennon.
First, we gotta break her from the witch bolt.
You're so mean to me.
Yeah. So, when Zashi realizes that she didn't have any rituals, Lucille takes out, makes her book of shadows pop out in her hands. It's like a big ass book, as big as she is. She says, I have some rituals in here if you'd like to copy them. It's always handy to have other people that cast magic, right? So, you know, you can help identify magic stuff, too.
Yeah.
What are you doing? Saki, what are you doing? He's, like, chewing on your backpack. He loves it.
Something needs to be tasty inside there.
Maybe.
Yeah, so you guys settle down. Are you trying to take a... It has not been...
Right?
Let me double check time. It is only 4 p.m., so you would need to wait quite a bit before you'll be able to start a long rest.
Yeah.
But you can begin to prepare for that now, and we can play the game accordingly, or if you guys want, we can also just do a short rest.
I'm pretty out of juice. I kind of need to take a long rest if I'm
same.
I mean, what we
can long do, rest sounds good.
Yeah, I think what we think we should do is we should just coop up in here until we can are able to get some good rest, and maybe plan and discuss tactics going forward.
Anyone have a deck of cards?
Actually, I just realized something. I might, seeing as I don't imagine we'll be sleeping for a bit, undo that work I just did to pull apart that barricade and maybe just spend the time while we're waiting, digging out some more of them crystals.
Mining! Yes, oh, that's a great idea.
Something to occupy myself with. And...
okay.
Pendriver holds up a card that says loud.
Yeah, that would be not a noise that might attract attention. Might want to hold off on that.
I mean, it didn't seem to be a problem before.
Well, we should get jumped instantly after.
We're trying to hide now, so I think we should keep quiet. But yeah,
What more could we attract?
What else is in here?
Don't know. That's why those crystal things.
From my mind searching, I didn't see anything else.
How many of those doors?
Blissfully ignorant.
Well, Gilly, we're at an impasse. So maybe some should stay and some should go mine.
I mean, we could. Zeke, I would say if you're gonna do that, we should have somebody else with you.
Definitely.
Into groups.
I mean, I honestly feel like that's very dangerous considering that we're very, very limited on our resources right now.
How about this? Take a breather, short rest.
Yeah,
Zeke
I guess.
Goes and digs while we make ready for the rest of the...
Yeah, that sounds good. And while we're doing that, Zashi, you can also copy Identify out of my book if you'd like.
Oh my god, yes, thank you.
I'd offer to let you copy the submission of entertainment, but I don't think my kin would be particularly pleased with that thought of that. So I don't think I'm going to share that one with you, unfortunately. Sorry.
That's okay. She's excited at the opportunity to get any more spells.
Alrighty, so short rest?
Short rest first, then you can go do your mining shenanigans as we wait out the situation.
And Dasi, if you ever do get any good rituals that you don't mind sharing, I'd be really happy to pick your brain for them too, anytime down the road.
Totally.
Same here, if I find any good rituals, I'll share them with you.
So we're doing a short rest?
Short rest first, yep.
Got it.
Alright, you guys have your short rest and are not attacked or intimidated whilst trying to short rest and successfully complete it. Congratulations.
We took a short rest before, right?
This is your second short rest of the day, yes.
Right, okay, so no arcane recovery.
If you already used it, yeah, you should have trackers and stuff. Yeah. And if you want to use hit dice, remember that you do only get half of your total hit dice back at the end of the day. Mm-hmm. Almost all of you will not be at full hit dice in the morning. I think everybody, except depending on how many Kill uses. Oh, Kill, one of the benefits of short resting is you can roll hit dice and to regain HP.
This was my first time spending hit dice.
you said roll.
So on your character sheet, underneath your HP, you have something called hit dice. It says like 6 out of 7 hit, and then it says hit dice, parentheses D8.
Oh, I see it. Yeah, it's total 7 under it says 6.
Yes. So you at the end of every day get 3 hit dice back. So if you roll 2, you can roll 2 more without going over your like the amount that you will get back. But anytime you click the word hit dice, it'll roll your d8 plus your constitution modifier, and you gain that much HP back. You can do up to 6, and you have it's up to you how many you want to spend. But you only get half of those back on a long rest. So you need 2 long rests to fully get back to your max.
So a short rest, I do just what? Just
you can
one,
do as many as you want.
Oh, okay. So it's just on a long rest, I get
half. Okay. Yeah.
Half that. Alright. So, boom. I get 2. Alright, so that's did it twice. I get 17.
So then rather than doing minus, you can just do plus. Yeah.
Plus 17. Yeah.
Yep.
Cool. Feeling much better.
Assuming we have time. Expecting you to eagerly go out digging more crystals, Captain?
Yeah, I mean, that's the plan. Don't not be an idol too long.
I have time
to keep. To be doing something. You want to come along?
I would, but I have something I want to try cooking before they are off. Pull out my cookbook from the hag and
a
couple of pages.
Oh, Jesus.
I'm gonna go do some mining. I don't know if anyone wants to be coming, but that's what I'm gonna be doing. No, stop.
Zashi will stand and go, I'm gonna come with you. Just in case.
Appreciate it. I'll move the stuff aside, but to the point where it can probably just be pushed back on. If that's possible.
I mean, yeah, you're definitely probably the only person that could easily push it around, but...
Yeah. So can I just go through, or...?
Yeah.
Pick your poison, I guess, Sheree. We got them all out here.
I have a few extra cuts already from earlier. Thank you, though.
Alright.
Work, slay.
Well, see y'all in a bit.
To start laying out the, a few things I have for my recipe and start cooking up the personal rations I have.
Crystals were north, right?
The ones you were working on before, yes.
Yeah.
There are
these
more.
Are not crystals?
No.
Or...
Right. Those are candles set amongst mushrooms. Alrighty.
Come on, Sparks.
Coming
immediately move south.
That is one animated table.
Hell yeah. Okay. Zeke begins to mine. We'll resolve that in a little bit. I assume you're just gonna mine until
the long
rest.
Time.
Okay, so let's talk about how the people in the room are going to spend their time until long rest time. Zashi guards Zeke, and Zeke Mines. Sheree, you're gonna go start cooking some stuff up. Would you like to make me a cooking check of any kind? You have.
I definitely don't have proficiency in cooked utensils.
So... Okay, why don't you give me a. Survival. I'll say a survival because you have the book in front of you. So, rather than just a straight.
We'll use our once per.
Oh my goodness! Once per on the food.
Oh no! My food! No. Oh. It's terrible.
Sheree, as you're cooking, you notice it starts to burn, and rather than immediately pull the meat off, you kind of watch and keep slowly turning the meat as it catches, and begins to crisp and burns up, and there's something in you that's just enjoying watching this flesh burn. It's hard to say exactly what.
Lucille pipes up from over the distance in your head. Why are you doing that? It smells terrible in here now.
Sorry. Just kind of got lost.
Can you, like, take the meat off the fire, please? Like, right now, please?
I turn it two more times and then take it off.
It is basically charcoal.
That did not go intended.
There's still an amount of satisfaction. It's not the same as cooking a good meal and eating it, but there is a sense of satisfaction deep in your chest.
Ugh, still I don't like this. Yeah, it goes over and says, if you don't mind, I'm going to make this acrid smell go away, if that's okay. I can't sleep like that.
I'm just going to enjoy the smell for a moment. You can clean up if you
want. Okay, thank you. She starts like putting the fire on, and she uses prestidigitation to override the smell with, like, you know, smells of flowers and shit.
Flowers and shit.
One brain cell. One brain cell.
Love it.
Does this smell seem a little ironically familiar to me? Like burnt flesh.
Not dissimilar.
Like you did after you hit by the lightning bolt.
Yes. That. Kill, what do you talk to me about what you're doing? You've got a couple hours. You're not in a bag. You kind of are helping these people who just seem to get attacked all the time. This place sucks, and there's still, like, a whole section that you guys haven't been able to access.
While I am sitting there in that chair, right, and the random smell of my home country, of the port that I grew up in, just the weirdest, craziest smell possible brushes through my nose as I'm looking through my weapons, inspecting them and cleaning everything. You know, I'm like, smells not too bad in here. It's pretty good, you know what I'm saying? This reminds me of home. And I'm still, like, cleaning off the slime and dragon guts and blood and all that stuff off of my things and off my arms.
Is Kill vocalizing this, or is this, like, inner monologue in his head?
It's just all happening. You're noticing this stuff, but it's all happening. And the smell, I vocalize that. I say, like, yo, guys, it's pretty good smell here. I know what you're saying. Like, I don't know what you guys are talking about. It smells pretty good.
Nice.
Right. I'm just cleaning my weapons off, having a good time. You know, I'm not in a bag, so I get to breathe the nauseous smells in the air.
Well, it smells rough at first, and then it smells like acrid. It smells like overpowering floral scents.
Yeah, you're like, what? So you say when you spray too much Lysol in, like, one place?
Yep,
exactly. It just smells like shit and Lysol.
Yeah, at least I had the terrible smell, and she just made it worse. It's like, and then she ties a bandage around her face and makes that smell like something nice, and hides in her bunk in her bed again.
I'm still cleaning my arrowheads and stuff like that.
It takes a lot to scrape this stuff off. Whatever it is, it's gotten in the little cracks and crannies, and it's a bitch to get out.
It's like if you use a knife to scrape off something from another knife, but then the thing you scrape off from the one knife gets on the other knife, so you use the original knife to scrape off the stuff that you originally scraped. Yeah, no, it's like an endless cycle, and I'm just, like, struggling over here, but, you know, I'm not, you know, physically mad or anything like that. It's just, you know, another day. Another grimy day, you know. It's clearly grime off of my weapon. Worse. Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah, so you guys probably realize that this guy isn't fazed by all the fucking bullshit in a way that most people you've met have been like, oh, what the fuck?
Yeah, it's just slightly discomforting, but all in all, I'm just, you know, kind of indifferent to everything. I'm just in there, just honestly, could not have been another just regular day. You know what I'm saying? It's just another day, another dollar type deal. Yeah, that's basically what I'm doing.
Hell yeah.
You seem pretty familiar with death.
Well, I've stabbed a couple things, so you know it's no big deal. Miss.
Any particular trophies you're proud of?
The only trophies I collect are information. That's it. Everything else I don't need. I'll dispatch and then get rid of and be on my way.
You're very professional.
I try to be. I try. While he's like, just taking off the grime off of his dagger is just impossible. It's just piles of slime on the floor. I'm not even like, I'm just looking straight at you while I'm talking to you, but I'm still scraping off piles of slime.
It's like every new piece of armor you unbuckle, there's just a thin veneer.
It's just a very thin.
Yeah. And you just have to scrape it out from your scales, just scale at a time, going around, scraping it off, then doing the corners.
There's more slime that I scrape off than you can visually tell. Like, it just becomes more and more. Just impossibly. It's like a whole mound at some point, and I'm still not done.
If anyone's ever seen a blender explode while it's been on, you know how your whole kitchen just gets coated in a very thin layer of it? And it's like, you keep finding it in more places.
Look at the roof and you're
passive. It's somehow on both sides of the armor.
Freaking
yeah.
Goddamn Elmer's glue factory exploded. It's all over me. And you know, I'm just like, yeah, Tuesday. Yeah, that's basically me spending my time there.
It's definitely going to be time well spent. Have more people to go, I assume, down wherever they are.
Wherever they are, they will die by my hand. Put me in a bag. God damn it, put me in a bag. The scraping becomes more vicious. And I'm just mumbling about a bag while I'm just scraping the hell out of the shit.
Nobody knows my sorrow.
Now I really know why the bagged birds sing. See, it doesn't go as well.
It doesn't hit as well, but it's still funny.
Alright. Unless there's anything else from the room, people, let's resolve mining. Thankfully, you guys have cleared out enough of this place that nothing seems attracted by the, let's say, 3 hours of mining. You started your short rest at 4 o'clock, so from 5 to around 8.
I would say after the first 30 minutes, Sashi has begun smoking.
Excellent. Give me a... are you also using this time to copy from Lucille's book?
I imagine economically she would probably do that later when she's on inevitable watch for their long rest.
Just, you know, figure out what spell. I think, Lucille, you said you have to identify and detect magic.
No, just identify.
Just identify. Okay, so figure out the gold cost for that. So that you have that ready. Okay. Zeke. 3 hours. Why don't we do 3 athletic checks? Just to quantify what sort of dice roll we should make to see how many of these gems you get. They are quite big, these ones. The issue earlier, but you've got more time now.
Can you give me a little bit of a hand here, Sparks?
Sure, what do you want me to do?
Just hold it steady, chip away at the parts I'm pointing at. Let me know if anything I'm doing might not be the best idea.
Sure. She kind of gets in close.
Appreciate it. Essentially, I'm asking for the help action.
She help actions.
Cool. Nice. So advantage?
Yes.
Yeah.
Very, very nice. So for a total of 50, let's say that's how many of these gems you unearth. As you continue going, it becomes clear as you start to excavate like a 5x5 hole in the ground over the course of these 3 hours that these things will just continue going down. It's as if they're gigantic crystal spears that get wider and thicker and the further down you go, as if they were jabbed upwards. It's almost reminiscent of sort of like a tripod leg as you kind of begin to picture it bigger and bigger in your head.
This is nothing like Minecraft.
So you...
Is this a prank?
You eventually resort to chopping the same sort of fist-sized sections off as you were able to collect green stone. And we'll say with those three rolls, you get 50 of these in the 3 hours.
Alrighty. Did we get any crystals beforehand?
No. You were interrupted whilst mining because the rest of your crew got restless.
So just crystal?
Yes. Mark them down in the same way that the other ones were.
This is where I feel like we should have grabbed the bag of holding.
At some point, Zashi's help action can include returning to go grab the bag of holding.
Yeah, sure. Zashi real quick runs back. Hey, I need the bag of holding. Got a lot of rocks.
Appreciate it. This should get us a pretty penny, I think.
Hopefully. You done good.
How many pounds of stuff are in the bag of holding right now? Do you perhaps need to enlist your friend with the cool backpack to help carry it?
And they're dead.
That's up to whoever is the...
Lucelle has the bag of holding.
Yeah.
How full is it, Lucelle?
Second here. Currently has leather armor, tabard, a bowl, a rosewood bowl, a set of crystal dye, which she actually has on her person now. She took it out. Play with it. Place them over there. It's got 180 GP, a set of merchant's weights, a vial of quicksilver, drafting compass.
Yeah, estimate weight. What is it, 500 pounds for a bag of holding?
Yeah. I mean, I think the biggest amount thing is that we have 2.5 weeks of food and water in there.
Oh, yeah. That was all of this stuff from the corner here.
Yep.
And that's everything all fresh else is
small.
Food.
It's small stuff, yeah.
I'll say you guys aren't at max, but you're probably near it.
Yeah. The bag is getting pretty full, y'all.
Do you think we can fit these rocks in there?
How much do they weigh?
Not all of them.
Not all of them? All right. Points to the...
I have room.
Points to the dragon guy.
I do have room. in my handy sack, my giant, ginormous sack, if you will.
Your enormous sack? How much does it hold?
Let's see.
Uncomfortable with this.
Uncomfortable with what?
You're mining. Unfortunately, Zeke, you're the only one not in this conversation. I wish you were there to object. It would make my life better, but...
So
it's an impressive sack.
Do I go to the sack and press like the little eye icon on it?
That would give you the description. I also created a handout. If you go into player handouts and acquired magic items, you should see the Heward's handy haversack.
Oh wow, let's keep the bag of holding away from this thing.
Yes, do not let them touch. Yeah. They are not allowed to kiss.
No kissing. Never put them.
Okay.
Wait, is it if they touch or if one gets put inside the other?
One and the other.
As they start touching it, it's inevitable it start trying to
inevitably it's going inside.
Yeah.
Got it. Work.
It's like a slip and slide.
the most awful idea. A sentient bag of holding that really wants to die.
A bag of holding that continuously, asks, put me in that other bag. Hey. Hey, why don't you put me in that other bag there?
Kill me.
It's just a real sensual, right in your ear. Like, every single 5 minutes is like, hey.
Okay, that's not what I was talking about.
See that bag? You should put me in that other bag.
Yeah, let me get in that bag, dog. Let me
get in that bag.
That's a really nice sack. Put me in that sack.
Enough!
Okay. Each side pouch can hold up to 20 pounds of material. So you could put 40 of the rocks into the two side pouches.
Yeah, sure.
Or all of them into the large central pouch.
Should I make my way down to the crystals to?
Sure.
Cool. I am coming. Ka-ching. All my style. I'm here.
Actually, Lucelle, remember when we get back, dump all of the food supplies, or not all of them, but a good amount of food supplies into the pantry.
I'll make, do you guys want a separate handout for thing, Kill, do you want a separate handout for things that are in your bag so you have a place to track them?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ka-ching. Ka-ching.
Kill is on his way, allegedly.
Yes, I am on the way, allegedly.
Lord.
Please tell him to shut up about his sack.
I'm afraid I can't do that.
I have no idea what's going on. Are you speaking about the absolutely ginormous sack that I have right now?
I cast a wall of fire. It goes directly through you.
You're not in range. I can't hear you. I don't know where the fuck you are.
Oh, my bad. It's on the north. Cool. Is this a door up top, right? Up here? Hold on, my computer's...
I'm just going to keep pinging. I don't know if you can see it.
I definitely cannot see it. Hold on. Which side? The computer's giving me issues. Ah, I see it.
Computer.
I'm seeing it. There he is.
Ka-ching.
Ah, yes, I'm here.
Behold.
Give me your bag.
My bag? Oh, sorry. You mean my sack. Here you go. It's the sack.
It's a bag. It's got multiple compartments. The sack only has one.
Not this sack.
Can we just call it a bag?
All right, here you go. Here's my bag. here's my bag. I go over there. I just start shoveling the rocks in.
It is my bag, baby.
It is my bag. I just under my breath.
You guys get 50 pounds of gemstones, 1 pound each, round fist size stones.
Nice.
They are, and they have a very, very faint glow from within, and are purple amethyst-like color, but slightly more clear.
Good shit.
Ooh.
I think you deserve some rest.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. I don't know. I guess I'm just frustrated that we haven't finished with this shit by now. I don't like being underground.
Well, we're almost done. I can feel it.
You're also technically underwater.
Oh, yes. I forgot about that. That part.
I prefer underwater to underground. Mm. Just the water around.
Yeah, Zashi says technically we're actually underwater.
I mean, I prefer underwater to underground, because at least water can't fall on you when you're already in it. But you can always get crushed by the ceiling if you're in a cave or some shit.
A spirited observation.
Yeah, what can I say? I'm a man of many talents.
So true, so true.
By the way, Cuddy, for someone who's afraid of water, you kill pretty easy. What's up with that? You've been doing that for a while?
Well, you see, that right there, well, the killing part, yes, I've been doing that for years. But the reason I'm so good at killing while I'm underwater is my fight or flight instinct. You see, I'm so terrified that whatever comes into grasp of me, that is my enemy, it dies within a few minutes. So, yeah, no.
Well, it seems a little more trained than that, if you don't mind my saying so. I'll start shifting the shit back over to blockade the door.
An animated table.
That table damn well better be animated. Oh my god, it moved!
You know, if folks is just scared, if they kill someone, they tend to panic afterwards. But you don't. And so I'm wondering what's up with that.
I grew up in the hard streets, you know. So also, it doesn't really help that watching my brother died in front of my eyes. So, you know, I'm kind of,
I suppose so,
indifferent to death.
Wait, are you trying to do like I'm more fucked up than you are? Because I feel like that's just a waste.
It's not a competition.
No competition at all. I'm just saying that either way.
I don't want to play that game. I don't care about playing. I'm just saying, are you playing that game? Because I want to watch. Look, it's funny as fuck.
Look, no. First off,
this guy.
I feel like, didn't we talked about the whole cannibalism thing. I do not wish to compete with anything. I'm still kind of, I'm a little scared, but you know, it's all right. Also, it's okay.
I'm literally rich. I would lose so hard.
Look, I'm not talking about, I just want to understand you. Consider this your belated job interview.
Don't worry, you'll be explaining who you are to Zeke for the next rest of the campaign. That's his relationship with every person and every.
Yeah.
Zeke's got a lot of questions and he wants them answered now.
He's a curious cat.
I'm about to say he's very curious and cautious. You know, I feel that's a good trait.
and don't let him intimidate you. That's his go-to, because he has a hard time talking to people.
I talk to people just fine. It's people who have a hard time Bullshit. Listening to me.
Isn't that a Shrek line? I don't have a problem. It's the world that seems to have a problem with me.
Maybe.
People take one look at me and go, ah, help, a big, disgusting Leonin.
Do you have layers? Similar to that of an onion?
I apologize. I could autistically quote Shrek all the way through.
I prefer parfaits myself, just saying.
Parfaits. Yeah. I don't... Would you mind telling us a little bit more about your story exactly? Because most folks don't just go out on a revenge quest when their family's killed. They just bury them and get on with it. I'm just wondering what makes you different.
Well, honestly, I don't have much else other than my brother Dag. He was the only thing that I could say, you know, he was the only family I had. So to take that from me, we grew up at a port. Small, small town.
There's a lot of ports.
Let's see. I'm sorry, what happened? I definitely did not hear what was said.
What is the name of the place that you're from? I believe you and I came up with it then we talked.
Did we? I don't remember. I'm not going to lie to you.
Oh, I forgot. I have Fine Familiar too. Shit.
That would be in the bio, but I don't remember.
I believe...
I remember you said, wait, did you tell me, it was, you told me something, I forgot what it was called, I didn't write
was
it down.
Was it Windhome?
No, it wasn't Windhome, it was a different one. I remember what I remember what it was called.
You hear, wait, let me take you guys to the world map brief.
Oh shit. Whoa!
Yeah, we'll roll out the map on the table as,
where are you? And he goes, it's been long.
See, I'm over here, and he points on the map where he's crossed out New Hosnia, Hosnia, and written New Hosnia.
New Hosnia.
No, it's called New Hosnia, Hosnia. If you look on the map here.
I know, but Zeke's on the map that we have has crossed out the first part and written New.
Feel free to draw on this map if you would like. I think you should be able to. I
will do that.
Holy
this
fuck.
Is if this is the ship's map, you guys are allowed to mark up stuff.
Okay, where did alright, damn, I wrote it down. I thought I wrote that down. I'm not gonna lie to you. Cause it was three places or three options that we came up with that night. I just don't remember which one was the one that was final.
I mean, you can make the decision now, if nothing else.
To say, if anything else, I'm just gonna...
You see, I was grown up around hereabouts. But, I mean, that place just about gets torn down and built every other week, so.
Where did... here. Wait. What is this?
Better that ooze getting your brain or something?
A little bit.
It's through the ears.
Let's see. Hold on. Well, okay. Picking this one right here. Boom. I just... See.
That one would not make sense for you to be from.
This one.
Quelisar. So that is one of the places that basically does not have races besides humans and elves and orcs.
Okay.
What? I believe we talked about Vayne Rune or the Lifeless Yonder as the
It was Vayne Rune. It was Vayne Rune.
Okay, so this orange, this big orange country up here.
Big orange
country. Here, let me just go through some names and tell me if you recognize any of them. Bronze Keep, Torn's Hold, Pelterel, Daystone, Alaron, Everwinter, Water Shallows, Baradusk, Quadbor, Lantern Watch, Gatefort, Grundbog, Bilkstead, Uttersea, Bellyard, Yatar Hog, Newfort, Sundbear, Svanog. Any of those sound familiar? That's most of the port cities.
No, I was about to say, you said, say it again, Svanar.
Svanog.
Svanog. All right, there we go. That's the one.
Okay.
Svanog. I remember Svanog. It was something. Svanog. Give me a second. Svanog. Svanog. Svanog.
Svanog.
Once a bustling with trade from a tribe, but 37 years ago, all trade ceased, and since the city has done nothing but shrink and grow poor.
That's what it was.
A city on the fall. Yes.
City on the fall.
Basically, all of the resources that used to go there now go farther south in the continent to help the war front.
So where's this?
Svanog is in the southern half of the Vayne Nation. It is near the middle of the river. It is one of the closest places to the ruins of Carl. Uttersea is the only other place that is closer.
Svan.
Just, it's not a place called Carl. It's just a guy called Carl who just fell over and died.
Just fucking yep. Collapsed on the floor.
As far as people from outside of Vayne Rune know, yep.
There we go. Alright, cool. And I'm marking on the map.
You grew up in some magic bitch place?
Extremely
poor.
I don't know, I feel like that's a pretty good description.
I mean, most of the Yahawk country ruled by magic bitches. I mean, this. Am I wrong? I mean, your whole thing is that you don't like him.
Magic bitches. Jesus
magic
Christ!
Bitch, it sounds like you're just. It sounds like you're talking about me.
Jesus Christ.
I mean,
Christ.
You are magic, and you can be a bitch, but no, I wasn't talking about you.
Jesus. Just a very, very very poor.
Boy.
Next to my boy, Carl. I knew him personally.
You did not. Please don't say that. If you guys, I think know. It would be nice for you guys to mark, like, take some time and mark the map if you want to make, like, write your names down near the cities that you were born in, that would be, like, no.
No.
That'd be great.
Hey, Nate, is there, like, a map of the Feywild? Just kidding.
I do not have one prepared. If you want it, it's gonna be the fucking Witchlight map. I don't want to use that one for reasons.
Oh, hey, could you attach an owl to my, as a familiar for me? Eventually she's gonna summon that.
Why is it so
Where's the Wizard College?
Which one?
I guess.
The College of Scribes?
Yeah.
The College of Scribes, I believe, is in Bilkstead, but let me double check. No, God, no. Yeah. Bilkstead, the largest farming community in the nation, in many cases worked by paroled prisoners from Nohoa. Though not a college itself, due to the large nature of trade outgoing from the port, causes a large influx as well. A massive library has been created here, worked by an order of mages known as the Scribes, who are also attempting to join the Wizards Council, and have been for some years. Not a college proper, but a place where that would have gotten you started in your endeavors. And you would have basically been able to attend classes there. They are just not recognized as one of the colleges.
Of course not.
We're circling the names. This is what we're gonna do. I like it. For our Feywild folk, would you like to circle the places where you first appeared?
I put my name next to it.
Where Shuri is.
Way over. It's real tiny.
Oh damn. Oh, it's so little.
Is Brill the place that we crashed at?
Also, we have a random mark here.
Shit. Is that you are here? Is that what that says?
Yes.
The blue random mark is, I'm not sure what that's supposed to be. That's gone. You are here is the place where the ship currently is. You guys are in.
Cool.
The deepest parts of the ocean.
That is not so comforting.
No, it's not.
How do you feel about the Mariana Trench?
Is there anything else you guys would like the world map for?
Was Brill where we...
Yes. That, the small village of Brill is very close to the shore where you wrecked upon after the storm.
Oh, I did not mean to draw a shape.
We have not made it far from No Man's Land.
I just realized this is super mega bitches. What?
That's the prison we all started in.
Yes, that's where we initially escaped from.
Ah, the super mega bitches.
Avoid at all costs.
I guess, I mean, while we're if we're about to commit to a long rest, I think that during that time, Lucelle would cast Find Familiar for herself in process, showing that ritual spell in her book to Sashi, so she can copy it down. Because it's only level one, so both the rituals she has that she's sharing are level one, so it'd be 50 gold per ritual she wants to copy.
Hell yeah.
So yeah, find familiar, and identify are available to you for cropping, and we have 180 gold in the bag of holding too that you can use towards that.
Okay, yeah, I'll do that, and I think it takes less time because I have the Blizzard Quill.
Mm-hmm. I think it's less time and it's cheaper for you too.
Two minutes per spell level. Wow.
Instead of an hour.
I think it actually would have been 2 hours, right?
No, because well, 2 hours for each for both spells, but it's just 1 hour per spell. And now it's 2 minutes because of what your skills do.
Oh, you guys are drawing the route?
Yeah.
Make sure you come down the river here.
Don't forget we did go up like here and then bounce back.
Yeah, if you want the mark back for the first island that...
Oh, yeah.
Bang. First island raise.
Nah, okay, it's just the time. But yeah, instead of an hour, you copy the rituals and you're able to figure them out in 2 minutes per spell. So 4 minutes later, Lucille's like, huh?
Yeah.
You watch your cast create the ritual to cast the spell, and you're like, oh, okay. And she's like, yeah, this might take you a little time because I know how much time it takes to copy spells for me. And then you're like, zip, and she's like, the fuck?
And I'm just like, I just like wave my hand, Quill shows up, write it down real quick.
Yep, yep. You flourish it out real fancy and just scribble down what you need. And like, okay, I got
I'm
it.
I'm imagining it's like a fucking bad animation rig where you just kind of have the hand moving like a fucking printer.
And Lucille's just like watching, like, okay, I am definitely going to make a copy of that memory because that was impressive as fuck.
So, like, I wonder, does she, 1 second.
So, yeah, Lucille, since I forgot about the ritual, I guess, retcon that she actually has the brass brazier either in her bag or she threw it in the bag holder, if that's cool with you, Nate.
The what?
You have to have a brass brazier to consume spell components when you're casting a ritual spell.
To cast Find Familiar.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because I completely forgot about having my spell book and
Whatever it costs, yeah, just subtract.
Cool. Yeah, I have the materials for it. Cool. Thank you. So yeah, she now has a little owl with her and I just finished that. I was like, well, there's the ritual for that. You got both rituals now. Congratulations. Now you can help me with figuring out what things might be cursed or are good for us, if they're fancy magic items. And you can also make it familiar.
Yeah.
And she's petting her golden feathered owl. Its feathers are like her hair, almost blonde gold. And it quietly like hisses and does a small screech.
Ow.
Scream, motherfucker.
And she also does something else while while you guys are finishing up. She's got the owl out, she's got her head petting his head, hand petting his head, and then you see her touch something on her wrist and goes zip, and now she's got no hand on her left hand and is now still petting the owl's head. She's like rubbing her chin with the nub of her wrist.
Oh yeah, Cutlass, this or Mr. Kill, this is the first time that you see the toothed bracelet in action. You look up and see a bright yellow zipper hanging off of Lucelle's wrist that you've never seen before, and her hand is about a foot away, petting an owl with a bright pink zipper half on.
Zeke is just really trying to resist the intrusive thought of rushing over and crushing the hand.
Squish the hand because it looks just like a spider.
Yeah.
Hey. Does Lucille catch a view of him about trying not to come after her hand?
He's not coming after it. He's just like looking over.
Oh, he's looking at. Okay, he's just doing. He's doing,
his jaw.
He's doing the cat shaking his bum at a light source.
No, he's just clenching his jaw and looking at it every now and then. Just mumbling to himself, no, don't do it.
Yeah, destroy the child.
Penisiver and Cherie are drinking their way through this bottle of wine, by the way.
Oh, 100%.
It is like, there's like a glass or two left in it at this point.
Been enjoying that and conversating. It's good stuff.
Hey, Lucille, what's your passive?
Her passive perception is 14.
Okay,
slime.
Good to know.
Slime everywhere! Fuck!
Oh!
I think that's just my intrusive thoughts.
Yes, thankfully. As the night begins to grow, or as the day begins to turn to night, you guys eventually do begin to feel the tiredness that heralds that you should sleep, though there is no indication of the time of day this far down. You know that you've spent at least 8 to 10 hours underground so far.
You're just making it even harder not to smash the hand.
Did I make that as the token?
I gave you that token.
You did that, okay. Because I had a good small-sized token set up. What the fuck?
What is that?
I'm not okay with this.
I found a picture of a thing.
What is that?
Alright, I've never done this before in a game ever, but I'm retroactively removing an item. Like, taking it back.
Oh, man.
All right, long resting. Talk to me about how you guys are going to rest for long.
My face hurts.
It's gonna in a minute.
Oh boy.
The rocks fall, the spell dies. You're back to a party on the floor. Pendulum, she has a skill overlap with Cutlass.
Zashi opts to take first watch.
I could take the Lucille, last two.
Lucille immediately like says, I'm gonna try to recover as much magic as I can so I can heal you all up if it's a bad situation. And she immediately snaps and starts snoring under her bag.
I'm happy to take second.
The owl flies over to a good perch that's not easily hit by something. So I guess she would have her fly over here, where we know that the path we came from is relatively safe compared to the other ones. But yeah, the owl
flies over here. Just kind of rip the top off the tent, wrap it around myself, and collapse on top of one of the sleeping bags.
I'll just saunter over to one of these chairs in the middle next to the table. Saunter over there.
All right. I mean, Kill, I don't know if what you have, what kind of back pad, like, what, or pack pad, but I think you should have, like, a sleeping bag and stuff.
Let me see. Do I not have...
Do you have a big fear of bags now?
that is a reoccurring thing now. I just have a... I have non-flashbacks.
If you go to your equipment, you have a dungeoneering pack. If you click the little eye, you can see everything that's in it.
Oh, okay. I was in the wrong place. Dungeoneering pack. Yeah. Let's see. What do I get?
Backpack, crowbar, okay. Hammer, tinderbox, water skin, no sleeping bag.
No. Nothing. No sleeping bag.
Nothing. You can commandeer one of the dead peoples.
Recommend.
That's alright. I've seen a lot of dead things today. I'm just gonna sit in this chair and just put my feet on the table and just lean back a little bit, and that'll be it.
Are you sure that right there in the room?
Nah, it's alright.
You can
all right.
Play on
it's
top
okay.
of it.
Nah, you know what? It's alright. It's okay. It's cool. And I also keep third watch if necessary. This also keeps me alert.
Alrighty.
I've already been placing a bag in here one time. I'm not gonna do it again.
I would love if you kept that as a recurring motif of your character. You hate bed rolls.
No more bags. No more bags.
Puffing away like a hobbit, for
okay.
sure.
So everybody except Zashi makes their way to a place to begin to sleep. Sheree, you're gonna make like Mr. Kill and set up in a chair for your trance.
Yep. Just relaxing.
Alrighty.
Meditating to myself.
Zashi, why don't you make a perception check and tell me how you spend your watch.
I spend my watch. Oh God, who's that dumb slut? Where? Zashi spends her fucking watch reading this book she found on conjuration and puffing on her pipe.
Hell yeah.
You suspect she doesn't even really get high anymore.
Wow. Sounds like a sad existence.
Damn. Shit.
I mean, like, she does, but it's not the same. You know what I mean.
And unfortunately, I do. Your watch will pass as you take notes on your... recently acquired book on conjuration. It talks about quite a few different subjects and the different nuances of summoning a fae versus a fiend versus an elemental and such on. And though you do hear sounds, almost all of them can be attributed to water moving or dripping, or splashing deeper in the tunnels of this tower. Nothing comes to try and batter down the door. Don't hear anything dragging away the corpses on the other side of this entrance. As far as you can tell, you are safe within the 2 hours of your watch.
All right, once my watch is done, I close my book. I walk my happy ass over to Zeke. I give him a little shake.
Rich.
She'll gesture. She'll gesture to the table and say, I left you half a bowl if you'd like to smoke.
Thanks.
Now, move.
I don't like that command in tone, but alright. Gonna do it anyway.
Big of you.
I sleep.
All right, Zeke, tell me about your rest, or your watch, excuse me. That was a bigger bowl than I thought it was. Woo.
Starting keeping a good eye around, eventually getting a bit bored and start scratching just real simple pictures into the table with his claw. And humming to himself, so.
Okay. Anything particular? A
maybe
single
just like
name,
the...
one you heard from Mr. Kill, repeated over and over again?
He just is scratching images of himself and what looks like a slightly smaller, scrawnier him. And he's just thinking.
On a ship that looks like the one you guys currently have, but slightly different shaped, leaner, a bit faster in the waves and
no, more in alleyways and just in simpler times.
Ooh, that a lot.
And still somewhat suspiciously eyeing Cuddy. But mostly just torn between reminiscing and hatred.
Hmm. Okay, give me a perception.
Righty. Sorry, I'm just opening the character sheet.
How fucking dare you ping? Like, disrespectful. What the shit?
Go ping yourself.
Go ping yourself. Dickweed.
You fucking...
Oh my god, the orange and the blue giving portal.
Focus ping. It's giving portal. Wow. Alrighty, you as well hear some sounds and things. For you, it is about the same. There's nothing that really can't be attributed to the sounds of the cave, except for one part where you very distinctly hear a loud rushing of water, muffled, heard, echoed from hallways and through closed doors, but still a rushing of water as if something, it almost sounds like unclogging a dam, that sort of rush of water that carries forward farther ahead and can like damage things on the shoreline. It's just like this very loud swell of water. And
is
then
a
series
like
a of loud... Is there like a what?
Is Is there like a rough direction, or is it just kind of echoing about?
From your point of view, it seems to come from all three doors. Like, it's sort of this very echoey sound. The walls carry it, the wooden doors that are not super well set into the walls, as you experienced, don't do much to stop it or muffle it. Mm-hmm. Similar to the scream of the creature when you had first entered this place.
Yeah. Are, like, the doors and stuff rattling? Is there, like, a small tremor going through the ground?
No. It is just this, like, loud sound. You've been hearing water dripping and moving and rushing. This is just the loudest water sound you've heard yet. And as your watch continues, you don't hear anything else.
Intrusive thought. This bit of ham looks like it's an eye that is looking at the pig meat.
You glance over and blink and the eye disappears. Was it really there? Was it all in your mind? So you can need you to save against madness.
But yeah. As I'm there, just sort of looking at the picture that I've carved. Sort of cleaning and caring for my blades and that. Making sure my claws are in good shape. Just sort of let out a heavy sigh. Stand up. As the stool creaks. And walk over to Cuddy. Just give his stool like a slight kick.
You perform the inception where he slightly starts to fall and wakes up.
Yeah.
I have a dream. And then
I'll catch him by the scruff of his necks before he hits the ground.
Oh, I'm sure the Whoa. Rogue wakes up with enough time to catch himself.
Woo! Just real quick, flailing my arms.
Right yourself, catch yourself, the chair slams down with a loud clack.
Exactly. No one heard it. Alright, got it. And I just make my way over here.
Also, real quick, Zeke, I assume you took the time to attune to the weapon? We didn't mention.
Yes.
Okay, you have attuned to the Weapon of Warding. You can no longer be surprised and all the other stuff that the Weapon of Warding does. The hand, nice. The hand that is up there. But... it's in the items thing.
Okay. Acquired magic items.
You would make your way back to your small bed that you like to make on the floor. And Mr. Kill, how will you spend your watch as you come over to this chair, which has been warmed by so far two butts?
Alright, so after I'm already awake and I move to the chair, I kind of just like, I don't know, I'm like just scanning the whole area, watching everybody, you know, sleep and stuff, listening, see if I can't hear nothing, you know, weird outside the doors and stuff. Just kind of daydreaming, thinking about the times I... as a kid, running around, getting into bullshit, you know, as kids do, smoking pot, you know, hiding from the law.
Oh, that, you know, that's a good point.
Regular kid shit.
Zeke, did you smoke the pipe that Zashi left out for you? Or were you too...
I did not.
Oh, okay, so, Kills, you look down, there's a packed pipe of weed sitting on the table, and everybody's asleep.
Everyone's asleep. All right, so this is what I do. All right, so I'm
and then
like,
you look over
and you
see that Shireen is no longer meditating and is fully awake.
My eyes are slowly creeping open as I probably see your hand going for.
I'm looking around back and forth as I reach slowly for the bowl, the already pre-packed bowl. You know what I'm saying? And also, I have a flame breath, so I kind of just like. Real quick, and it just lights on fire. And it starts moving. Yeah, just a quick little whoop, you know what I'm saying? And
that's
it's just
so
fire.
Dope.
And then I just start hitting it, one hit.
But
I don't cough.
Take a character inspiration. That was fucking dope. Oh, what that means is if you go to your character sheet. Above where you have saving throws, you see the proficiency bonus, and there's something that says inspiration.
Yeah, I see that.
If you click, yeah, now you have one. So you either have inspiration or you don't. While you have inspiration at any time, you can invoke a reroll. You can basically give yourself advantage you just say, I want to use my inspiration. I also give everybody a once per session reroll, so this is in addition to that.
Okay. So I hit the bowl, and I get inspiration, is what you're telling me.
Yes.
I fucking love that. I love every second of that. I'm still perceptive, I'm still looking around, but I'm so high that if nothing, I'm just chilling. I'm just chilling. Yes. I'm so high
being
and happy.
Chilling.
Being chilling.
Give me a perception check.
Gotcha. Hold on. Let me pull out the gat, you know, as they say, as the kids say.
Big chillin'.
Big chillin'.
Big chillin'.
I want a clip of that.
Oh, shit.
That scared me so much.
I'm sorry. I couldn't resist. Yeah, you enjoy your smoke, and though you are perceptive, you are not as perceptive as you should, as you sort of just kind of slowly watch Cherie get up and make her way over to the table and sit down next to you.
Without a sound, like, we don't even say anything, I'm just low eyes, my eyes are kind of, like, they're already red, you know, because dragon head, whatever, but, like, for some reason it is a slightly, like, brighter red. But you can't really tell because, again, my eyelids are like I'm big chewing right now. So
she will pull out one of the three bottles she has left over of the rosé.
Oh, shit.
And pour out a cup for
the
you.
The substance use.
And kind of look to you, prefer
your parents.
Oh, yeah, I guess that's true, huh?
Nice cup like that. Big chilling.
And she will chill it a little bit with
shame. Ooh.
Oh, okay.
I mean, if you're going to enjoy yourself, company might as well be there.
You know what, I like your style. I like it. Just insanely high.
Honestly, been enjoying everything you've brought already anyway. Right,
just
professional
take
standards.
Friggin' takes like another hit of the bowl. A slightly smaller hit, though, because I'm already, like, teetering on the edge. And just... That's all you hear. Just silent coughs.
Just a very big smile watching him fucking fight through the pipe.
Jake probably actually, with the Weapon of Warning, wakes up a couple of times when he normally wouldn't and throws something at you.
It would only be... the weapon would only be for danger.
Okay.
I can't imagine that somebody smoking...
I don't know. Is lung cancer danger?
No.
Is lung cancer...
Get lung cancer from me.
Get lung cancer from the Swede?
Yeah, you can. You're not supposed to smoke anything.
But not from the Swede is different.
Willie Nelson.
It's different because we will it to be different.
How about this? It's different because it's Dungeons and Dragons.
Yes.
This is a fantasy game.
This is real life.
Unless you're going to do one of the things that I have marked aside as hard drugs, you're not going to have any ill effects from drinking or something unless you make it a chronic problem and talk up to me about that.
Where's my space cocaine?
Can we work in a lung cancer arc? Can we?
Hard
Zashi gets lung cancer. It would be fucking nuts. Because the answer to that is you just go home and then your family would get somebody to cast regenerate on your lungs.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just
you would spend 2 months in bed regrowing your lungs for a mountain of gold, and then and the party
which
would go on.
Which my parents gladly put the bill for.
To get you back, and they'd chain you to your desk. Yeah. Well, it depends if they actually hate you or not.
And perpetually, honor. Perpetually, Zashi, just like, dreams of her pirate days.
Oh my god, that's actually what's happening. This whole thing is just in Zashi's head because of their lung cancer from smoking too much. They didn't actually Holy go to shit. Jail. They just passed out on the floor one day from their lung cancer.
What kind of fault are stars?
Inception.
Yeah, no, this is Inception. You were asleep the whole time.
Jesus Christ.
But everybody is really real.
Fucking hangman's
Jesus.
Zashi asleep thinks, wow, if this is my dream, I am a piss poor dreamer. No, not the events. No, the people.
damn it.
The events are great, but you cannot always choose your protagonist.
I'm like so high. I have like high people thoughts. And I'm just looking over. And I'm like, what if I'm just a character in somebody else's dream right now? I'm just looking over at everybody. It's just like,
it's so Zashi to think that she's the one that's dreaming the thing. Like, that is so her vibe. Everything is about me, right?
Hearing Kill mention that, especially the high thoughts, I'm like. Ever think of the fact that we're probably on, like, some god's fingernail?
I look over, and I'm just like, have you noticed that whenever you get more bedroom, you lose less bedroom? Or some dumb shit like that? I'm just saying
Shower thoughts.
Yeah, just fully
just, what does that even mean?
just dumb shit the whole time.
fully indulging in this with Kill, just talking at the dumbest fucking thoughts possible.
To be said.
Shri, why don't you give me a perception at you and Kill talk.
Talk over some nice chilled water. Oh, hell yeah. I'm fully...
You
it's
are
fitting.
Fucked.
I'm fucked in fucking...
It's been a long day that you've been. Okay.
Probably the first time in a long time, and no one else gets to see it, but Shri just smiling and relaxing, full-blown, no issue, no guard.
Wow. So what, give me a piece of what you two talk about as you're basically not very aware of what's going on outside. It's an 11 and a 4.
I'm curious.
Watch 3.
Especially with all your inquisitive thoughts. Enjoying that smell out of the air. That's a mishap of cooking. You seem to be very at home with murder and the sort. How'd that lead up in life, or was that just out of addiction?
What's the, so I look over, right? And I'm just like, whoa, living on the streets was hard for me and my brother, right? So it was, you know, always difficult. But the one thing that I always put up to sleep was that smell. The smell of, and I'm just like sitting there thinking of what that smell was, like what it could possibly be, like the most, like, raunchiest, disgusting, like it smelled like cat's feet and radishes. in that alleyway every night before we went to bed, and That smell put us right to sleep. It was great. It was magical times back then. I'm just reminiscing about the fucking sewers or the streets covered in like just shit. But that was our home. smiling and happy and shit.
Breaking into different places every couple nights. Place boarded up that you could squat for a couple days.
As you can squat, but the, just so happens
the good that, times where you found a place where you were like able, like there was a winter that you found a place that you were able to stay there for like 4 of the 5 months of winter, and it
exactly
made it so much easier.
It was just unfortunate because we were also not only we're not the only poor people there. That bedroom was somebody else's bathroom at some point, so it smelled like the purest of ass, but it was nice and warm. You know what I'm saying? I'm just reminiscing about that.
And then one day you got on a ship and never came back.
Exactly. And I'm now high underwater.
Underwater.
With a
high underwater. You guys saved me.
You guys saved me from a bag. I don't trust bags anymore. Or other people trying
you
to sacrifice
me.
You have
new triggers already.
Yeah, no, I'm already traumatized. just more traumatizing thoughts, and it's okay, because I'm alive. Smoking shweed.
Tree, do you respond with a story of any kind, or do you have some kind of response to this story? Or these rambling stories?
Very curious, honestly, of what happened to your brother. I've got quite a big family myself back home.
He was a very, very clever man. If you know, if there ever was one, he knew how to. Well, he was very good at finding money, if I should say that. He's very, very, very good at finding money, you know. He was smart, cunning. You can never, well, other than that one time, you can never catch him, you know. And yeah, he was a great man. He was honestly a very, very good role model, you know. Very good. It was me and him against the world, you know. He takes like another like half of a hit, whatever is left in that bowl, whatever is left in that bowl that was packed. He takes more of a hit. He's just like, yeah, good shit, good shit, yeah.
I understand him not wanting to return home. Especially for it being so difficult you grew up.
Very difficult, very. But it wasn't too bad. It wasn't so bad. It's just once my brother was killed, I didn't see much of a need to stay there. So I packed my things and left.
Looking for.
You know, he also wanted me to explore the world anyway, so, you know, this makes it better.
Ever decide on looking for those who killed him?
I'm going to find that entire crew, whoever was responsible, especially the Jagged Diamonds. That man, he needs to die. That thing needs to be put down. How I'm going to do that, I'm not quite sure. I don't think he should be get off. I don't think he should get off with just simple death. I think that's too much for him. But we'll see.
Well, there's plenty of ideas that I could assist with if we do capture him.
I do like that idea. I like the sound of that. I like that. May I ask, what ideas do you have in mind?
Trigger warning. Josh is about to talk in Cherie's voice about killing somebody. Everybody watch the fuck out.
I'll keep it short, but it would probably entail keeping them alive as I carve and cook body parts from them.
Well, you know, not gonna lie, I think if I find that guy, I'm just gonna shoot him your way. I think that'd be a great idea. It just turns into like a business transaction all of a sudden.
I would more than happily practice cooking on that man.
Interesting.
I mean, you are fascinating. Not too often you meet professionals in such a relaxed standard. Then again, it's hard to find anyone more than happy to kill someone that's pay and such integrity.
Killing is also, how should I say? Killing is more of a business, an art, you know, of a sort. You know what I'm saying? But also a business in a way that if the whole world goes around with killing, you know, the whole world goes around. So I feel like we could make some arrangements for this man's capture. And we could definitely tag team, you know, throw some ideas on the wall, see what sticks when we get this guy.
I'm fully for it. Can't let him rest this whole day.
No rest.
Watching, you know, parts of him vanish or wither away over time.
We're just sitting here, just talking about torture methods the entire time. but like, in a slightly subtle way. It's like, oh yeah, no, I've been that. We're just talking back and forth. The whole time while everyone else is asleep. Just nice and exactly nice and taking sips from the wine and shit like that, just going at it. Both of us at some point don't even know where the fuck we're at. We're just talking about shit.
If I ever get far enough in my skills of cooking as well, I doubt I could tempt you, but you're more than welcome to share the plate.
I always try one thing once, so I don't know. Alright. We'll see.
Then I will have to work on my recipes for sure.
You always gotta try new things in this world. Something my brother said.
Very smart.
Before he unfortunately got, you know, he got wrecked. Just taking more sips of wine. I don't think there's anything left in the bowl.
Just polishing off that bottle.
Yeah, for real. I'm cleaning out the bowl, making sure it's nice and clean. No more ash.
I'm curious, in your travels, possibly heard of any musicians going by the name of Volren Glenn?
New musician? No, actually, if not.
That's a shame. Kind of hoping to thank her for everything that's kind of happened.
You said a musician?
Mm-hmm. A bard.
traveled with her for a time. Very cute.
Very, very cute. So, interesting. Take some of this in. Tell me more about your travels with this bard of yours.
Well, to a professional, someone who's a novice, I would consider myself to be, as much as I've taken some thrill in the exciting parts of the hunt. Obviously, planning I've learned is important, as you've stated. But she was one of the few to kind of distract me for a time, though. Provided absolutely an extraordinary cover. It's that moment of wolf among sheep, and the naivety of pieces being picked off and not really knowing who or how it's happening. But she's... the reason I ended up getting... stuck. But also a little bit of a benefit of what I have now. The only one to ever really catch me, if you understand.
She's picking up what you're putting down.
Oh, yes. She is so extraordinarily thrilling. Shared a few nights with her, but obviously under suspicion and curiosity after some wonders of why I would up and leave led to my tastes being discovered. It's a good 10 years ago.
I'm sitting there, like, my eyes are, like, still, like, halfway shut, but I'm, like, so into the story that I'm, like, slowly but surely opening them. Just slow as hell, just as slow as, like, non-squint. I'm like, huh.
I have expected her to disappear. She's amazing. Did learn a few songs. Fortunately. It kind of seemed like the world had different choices and destinies for us. It did hurt that she turned me in. Still feels like a betrayal.
Turned you in?
Yes. Like I said, she was naive to what I was. I kind of discovered it in the midst of a hunt. I didn't have any magic back then. It was my own two hands, much like you practice on your own skills. But I definitely was not anywhere as masterful in the artistry as you over there. It was sloppy.
With any amount of practice, any skill can be perfected.
That's the intention. Of course, I still look forward to possibly thanking her if I could ever find her.
Not if, when. You must always think on the positive.
And you should get some sleep.
Right. I'm like already like half asleep, but I heard the entire conversation. It was just I'm like speaking like my soul is speaking through my body, but like my body is definitely already asleep. So I take my half sleepy self and I go back to my chair.
Mistral.
And then as I go to sleep, I like mumble something about a sack. My ginormous, humongous, just snoring.
Right? That would leave you alone on what?
Mm-hmm. Finish out the watch, listening cautiously.
The owl floats over to Cherie and just quietly clicks his jaw and then nestles her and then starts watching the doors with her.
Offer a piece of ration.
It's snoring. Talking about a sack again.
Oh. Nightmares.
Not the sack. Please.
But that.
You're gonna have such a fucking rough time when it comes to hammocks.
Can I have the owl roll perception check too?
Sure. It is advantage. It is only for its sight.
Yep.
Who paused the bucket?
Actually, the owl has hearing and sight.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so advantage. Perception.
Get through this night.
Bam. Not a nat 20, just dirty 20.
Alright. The both of you, are, both the owl and Cherie are not aware of anything that's coming to attack them.
Hmm.
Unless there's anything specific you'd like to do, Shree, we'll give everybody a long rest, and you all begin to wake up.
Staring at the barricaded door as I just listen over here as well.
All right, everybody begins to awaken. You all have gotten a full long rest. You can click your long rest buttons and get all your shits back. Except for your hit dice, of which you only get half, so three at this point.
A glorious long rest button.
Hey, sure, sir. Sure, try not to bother the dragonborn snooze by. You know what? It's really funny. I completely forgot I had this ritual for so long. But I actually haven't named this little dude. And the little dude is also is actually a celestial creature, not a fae. She summons it from a different plane. So I actually have a name for it. I think we should call it. She pets her owl. Celsius is at enter the bag. Oh, okay, she sneaks over. Got it. She definitely does not notice the bag getting removed from her while she's talking to Cherie.
Oh, shit. That's smooth.
The delicious sounds of breakfast waft over to the noses of those still sleeping. Kill, you've gotten your last 2 hours as Sheree stayed up for the last watch. Zeke and Zosh, you guys all are fully rested and are able to wake up. The smell of breakfast, which smells much better than damp cave and death.
And action.
Alrighty, let's get this shit done. Get the fuck out of this hole.
She frisbees a piece of toast with a beautifully cooked egg inside to you, Zeke.
I just catch it in my mouth.
Excellent. Zashi, she throws you one.
I catch it with my hand. My mage hand.
Oh! She'll go one at a time throwing everybody one, including the owl, which she throws one of the, like, small cutouts of the bread.
Little triangle piece.
With no egg, because that would be fucked.
I'll catch it, definitely. Lucelle gets a slice of bread with an egg on it right to the face. She's like, ah, shit! Smacked her in the face. And it falls the floor.
You get yolk all the way down your face.
She doesn't mind that. She's like looking down at it. Tasty. Ah, shit, it's going to get hair in it. She picks it up.
Are those things in the other room humanoids? To the north of us?
No, they were undead.
Okay.
No.
And has it been more than 24 hours since we killed the other humanoids in the room next to us?
Not yet.
Okay, Sasha is
going. Oh, dear.
Sasha's gonna go collect some blood.
Zeke, could you please help me move this fucking thing?
Yeah, about that. Pretty much that, yeah.
All
right. So probably Dixie or Nikita.
Thank you.
The table's alive.
It's alive. It's gonna fucking kill everyone.
Roll initiative. The table chooses its moment is now. Right after you've had a long rest.
Imagine. I want you at your best.
You guys all watch as Zashi walks over and begins to strategically bleed one of the more intact corpses. It does take a little bit, because they've been lying there for 18 hours.
I just look while I'm eating the egg sandwich very slowly, and just watch her. Just
move over, sit in front.
Yeah, exactly.
I fill up just one vial. It's probably all I need right now.
Twiggy, who's this Dixie or Nikita? What's that?
Suggestions of the owl's name. This, you had something, Captain?
Oh. No, not yet.
Panzer holds up a card that says Panzer.
I agree. Two Panzers would be nice. Right.
Zip and Zip Jr.
You see, it's like she tries to change her form to make it like the owl, but it just sort of wiggles at the outer edges. It becomes a little bit feathery and then just goes back to how it was before.
Just feathery pants of her for a moment and just...
For just a second. It's like indistinct to, like, low def.
Oh, PlayStation 2 pants of her.
Oh, no.
Triangle titties. Is there anything else you guys would like to do besides breakfast and acquiring blood? Plant some beans?
Beans.
What the fuck?
I have that beans. Thing, right? I forgot.
We tried planting it before, because it's all grown.
Who has the beans?
I have
unfortunately,
the
Lucelle.
I don't think
and she has told no one.
Nobody knows about it.
I'm not worried about it.
About the beans? Just spill the beans.
She got the beans, bro.
I guess, yeah, would there be any dirt in this area? Because it's been stone the entire time.
I would say, actually, yes. As you look into the corners and the edge of this room, you guys all take a moment and notice that there are more mushrooms and mold growing up and around the walls. Significantly more than yesterday.
Ooh,
it's
good.
As if it's growing double or triple the speed that it normally would. And as Lucille, as you walk over to one of the corners, you actually are able to watch a particular branch of moss spread in real time. It's not fast, but you are watching a tendril very slowly push its way out and stick to the piece of
armor?
Like mortar between the two blocks as it's crawling its way up the wall. And like the corners of this room now do have exposed dirt because of that. It is just covered by this moss.
Oh yeah, no, Lucille, I guess while everyone's eating, she's already gobbled her thing because it was a partially investment she got it. She's quietly walked over and just investigating the thing. And then she's going to quietly take a bean out of the bag.
I also have one additional question.
Yes.
Did anyone have any levels of exhaustion this morning?
When you were Lucille, waking up Lucille, from Lucille did.
Okay. Lucille, you have a little bit of a restless sleep. Would you please make me a constitution saving throw to make sure that you are actually able to reduce your level of exhaustion?
Yes.
And just as a clarifying question, are you immune to the poison condition?
Lucille is not immune to poison.
Good to know.
Shit.
Okay, you do get rid of your level of exhaustion.
Sweet.
You are tough enough. A single night of sleep is not going to keep you up. Or hold you down, I guess I should say.
Gotcha.
Never gonna keep you up, never gonna hold you down.
Never put you in a bag and throw you around.
She looks at this, she gets closer to the mold, and then she notices the dirt, and she can't help but reach into her belt pouch. Or I guess it's a sling pouch. Yeah, she's got a sling pouch. She reaches inside, and digs her hand into the bag of booked beans, and pulls a bean out.
Beans!
And I just roll a D100 to see what it is when I bury it, or no, it's when I just bury it.
I should probably roll.
Yeah.
Do you roll?
No, you roll, because she's just reaching in the bag. So
Do it, destroy yourself.
Remove one of it, and then water it, produce, alright, so you do it, and then you just walk away, back over to the group?
No, you have to water it too, right?
Yeah, you do, but it then takes a minute. You don't have to water it for the whole minute.
Yeah, but she does. She has. She can't produce water, but she has water skin with her. She takes that out and starts pouring the water on it.
About to watch the apocalypse happen.
And then she quietly skips to the group and is now just chilling by Panzerfer, occasionally nervously looking back at the corner.
What'd you do?
Huh?
What did you do?
I was just messing with the moss over there. It was real cool. It was moving faster than normal.
You did it.
Oh, no.
You did it, didn't you? It's a pyramid, isn't it?
you look back in the corner, and you just a sarcophagus pops up. It's like, oh, no, another sarcophagus.
What the fuck?
So how the fuck?
Nate.
Jesus.
Nate. What'd you do?
I didn't do anything!
I'm scared. He's very quiet.
Lucille, could you roll me a D6?
D6?
A D6, please.
I'm scared.
Maximum.
Oh, good!
What does that mean?
Alright, you guys have 1 minute to talk. Please talk amongst yourselves. Give me a minute.
Oh my god, is something bad gonna happen?
Yes.
I'm very scared. What just happened?
It's not gonna be great.
Everybody back away from the fucking bean.
Can I take can I take a movement?
We
can I like
nobody
back?
Knows. Nobody knows what's happening.
We don't know that this is just a conversation at breakfast, baby.
Yeah.
Oh,
you guys are having a Quentin Tarantino breakfast while the apocalypse is happening.
So we got votes on Pensifer, obviously, for the or Pensifer Jr.
Pensifer Jr. I actually like that, so PJ.
Oh, PJ.
Oh, I like that. I like that a lot, PJ.
I think Pansifer likes it too, right, Pansifer? She looks over and smiles. I think its name's gonna be PJ.
He's in the middle of writing Pansifer 2 on the thing. And then she looks up kind of with a thoughtful look on her face. She'll flip the card over and she writes PJ2.
PJ2.
I can agree with that.
I like it. PJ2, how do you like it? And the owl goes, And then she dismisses familiar.
Okay.
Just because we keep it safe.
Give me one more second. Alright, there is a rumbling sound from the dirt as you guys look over at that patch of earth which begins to bubble and boil and give you all quite a bit of trouble.
What the fuck did you do?
What is that? What is that in the corner?
At this point, Pazmer just like looking like a little kid on Christmas, just watching the thing with trepidation, clutching your hands and wringing them, and giggling maniacally, and saying stuff in Sylvan. Oh shit!
What the fuck did you do, Giggles? What did you do?
I don't know, but I think we should move away from that corner.
I'm leaving. As you say that, before any of you have the chance to move,
hold on.
I need to
get that lower rest room.
God
blows up.
Damn it, Lucille.
Just hide on the other side of the non-animated table.
It reminds me of like those giant wheel spools, right?
Just so you know, Giggles, I'm gonna hurt you just as much as whatever this thing is hurts us.
She looks over.
The earth bubbles, and that whole section of the floor explodes as from underneath the ground, gigantic mushrooms push upwards and into the air, and immediately as they begin to as they break out of the earth and into the light, they emit this horrible audible shriek that rings in the air, and you do not know it, but it is fucking out to 300 feet. This shrieking goes. It is unbearable as you clap your hands over your your ears universally.
My ear holes.
They just continue screaming. They just scream as Lucelle falls into the square next to one. They're just they're as big as any of you. They're medium sized. They're just these giant mushrooms that are screaming. Here, let me get some screaming audio for the watch together.
No.
Was it the Death Eaters from Harry Potter?
Oh my god.
The Nazgul.
But yeah, Lucille, I have kicked you into them.
She gets flung into the middle of this pile of screaming. Just,
I feel like that's an appropriate and very reasonable reaction.
Are they doing anything? Like, are they attacking?
Just
are they fucking
screaming at the tops of their little plant bodies?
Z, go ahead. If you kick me hard enough to make me fly across, because I'm not flying right now. How much? Just I guess roll bludgeoning damage because she's not gonna miss it. She's totally absorbed with this chaos that's happening in front of everybody else and watching your reactions.
I don't know, man.
Yeah. So how much damage do you do?
I don't know.
Roll your strength then. If it's just an unarmed strike, strength plus. Yeah.
Do you guys want to attack these things, or would you like to try and clear out?
It's more of a shove.
But effectively, do you guys want to start a combat thing with these, or are you guys
going to
try and leave? Let's roll initiative for some mushrooms.
I would like to roll, a nature check to understand more about the mushrooms, too.
Absolutely, you can do so on your turn. Cool. All of these things are going to go on one turn.
Literally, like...
Oh, good, they rolled zero.
Running
Excellent.
Out the fucking door, because my ears hurt so bad.
Oh yeah, it's awful.
It rolls zero. Wait, is that a real thing?
Zashi's trying to remember if she can cast blindness deafness on herself.
Oh, that's genius.
That's really funny. Zeke, Lucelle, Cutlass, Sheree, I'm missing Zashi and Panoziver. It did not. I do not have it for me. There we go.
Sparks, can you burn these things?
Sparks, it's your turn.
Oh my god. Of course I can.
And burning hands would probably do wonders.
Just be careful about hitting Lucelle.
Am I gonna be careful?
Your call.
Draw a cone for me, Zashi.
She made a bed she can eat in. She can sleep in.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Weird.
Fairy on mushroom stew.
Yeah.
Make sure you snap it to... Is it snap to wit? Yeah, there you go. In the option to... It says lock. There's like a thing. The exact thing is lock width to height. Yeah, perfect. Whatever you would like to do.
Lucille, I'm so sorry.
Are you though?
This one, right here?
I think I can get the most that way.
So it only gets them if it's half of their square or more, half of their token or more. So with this one, you are only going to get five, actually, over there.
If you do it just straight up, that should probably
get... That is seven, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, work. I'm going to do that.
Okay, give it to me, and I'll start doing stuff.
The murder train.
That's a universal fail.
Booyah!
Lucelle, we also need you to save against that.
Gotcha.
I should have cast it up, but I don't want to kill Lucelle by accident.
Is it deck save?
Yep.
Uh-oh.
You are going to fail and take the full 11. Okay.
Sorry, Lucelle.
No, you're more than bloody all seven that you hit, and they scream if anything louder. Cherie, you're out of the room. It has done nothing for the level of volume. This is audible for hundreds of feet. Is that going to be you, Zashi?
Yeah, that's me.
Alrighty. Banazever is just going to pull out a sickle and go to town. Seven. Fucking again. 15 hits again. For 10, she slashes this one into pieces. She's gonna go for this next one. 19 hits for 19. She rips this one apart with sneak attack. And she just kind of looks over Zeke and shrugs and takes a step closer.
Free XP.
Cherie, you're outside of the room.
I'm gonna fucking continue, because I hate how loud it is. Fucking go around the corner for a moment, closing this door.
Jesus Christ. Banging her head in a wall.
Fucking take a moment as I... fucking mage armor up, expecting some horrible shit to come running to this sound.
Sure. Is that gonna be you?
Yep.
Alrighty. Lucelle. You just got hit with some flames.
Which made
with
a
seven. You have no idea what these screaming mushrooms are. They're mushrooms and they're screaming.
They're kinda cool. I guess I have a cool one. She's gonna use Green Flame Blade.
Excellent. You should probably move out of one of these things' squares.
Yeah. She moves back. She's still on the ground.
All of the ones that you move away from use their reaction to shriek. They shriek.
Oh my god. She's covering her ears. It's definitely painful, but it's not hurting her, so she doesn't care. But she's going to use the, Silver Dagger.
Fourteen hits.
To here.
That so 12, one's dead. 12
from the rain, and then she also does splash damage.
To which one?
I guess the one to her very exact left, right here.
Okay, that one dies as well.
So, splash damage would be.
Yeah,
super dead. Dead.
2 HP. Okay, that you.
Mm-hmm.
Zeke. Burn a rage, do it.
No.
Do it. Do a rage. Do it. You know
he's
you
angry, but rage. If he goes in, he knows if he goes into a rage, he will kill Lucelle. So he's not going to. But he is going to angrily shout, Lucelle! If you want to be on the crew, you have a better have dang good explanation for this. And I'll start shredding.
Okay, go for it. Sward.
Yeah, I will use Sward.
Sward. That will hit.
Oh, okay.
Hey, these things have an AC of 5.
Nice.
9 slashing bloodies, but does not kill this one.
Swing again.
13 hits.
Oh, so
you
that
chop
second,
it to pieces.
That second green flame blade, that I didn't mean to have the extra damage on for the first swipe. It was supposed
fine.
To be the bonus.
It had 2 HP. You were going to kill
cool.
it no matter what.
Cool beans.
Your charisma.
No, I'll step forward.
Hell yeah. Mr. Kill. You gonna just lazily shoot from your chair?
I'm just over there. How many feet do I have again to move?
32.
30 feet? Alright, so I'm gonna
not
move.
Not funny, but not helpful.
Alright, so I'm gonna move right over here. And then I'm just gonna stab one of these things.
Sure.
So. Because I can't, so we're just gonna hit him with the this.
What sword? Did you mean the bow?
I said bow, that's short. I meant short sword, not short bow. My
bow. Oh, should still be the same bow.
Well, sure, yeah, it should.
Just give me the short sword. 9 hits. You get sneak attack on this one because Panda Zipper is also next to it.
And annihilate that room.
Give it to me.
Sneaking attack, you say?
Mm-hmm.
Because of Panda Zipper in the cell.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Oh, crap, it's not okay, cool. And I just pressed short sword, right?
Yep.
There you go.
Absolutely eviscerated.
Nice. Kill the mushroom thing. Still screaming.
Yes, the other ones are still screaming. You did silence one of them.
You have your offhand attack still, right?
You can still make a dagger attack.
I do have the dagger, right?
Yeah. And
let's
you still
do
10
that.
Feet of movement.
No, oh no. Alright,
okay.
Cool. Dagger.
18
boom.
Hits. Damage. Just gonna be 1 on that one. Because you don't get sneak attack. Can't do it twice in a turn for an offhand attack. You don't get to add your deck. So you score that one and it goes, ow! On their turn, all of the shriekers shriek. Zashi.
God, this is tedious.
Yes.
I move forward, and I fucking... I think I have a quarterstaff, right?
Okay. Probably. Bop. Quarterstaff bop.
Yeah, give it a bop. Give it a bop.
Okay.
A two-handed bop.
Sure. That'll hit.
Dude, can be right there.
Was you smash it? It's dead. Congratulations.
Woo! Yeah.
You get where you are.
Yep.
Okay. Cool. Sickle dot dot. She kills this one. It's dead. My Uber is here. Fuck. 13 hits for 10 kills. She just is going down the line killing these things.
Jesus.
And she kills this last one as well. Oops. And I gotta go grab my food. I'll be right back. I'm sorry.
He devours the plate.
Devours it. Ow. You can't be on my desk.
Says you, I'm a cat.
That's what I'm saying, like, he just... No, you can't do... No. No. Ow! Son of a... No! Be nice. Stop trying to attack my hand. What is wrong with you? No! Please? I know what you're trying to do. I see you. Why are you meowing at me? I did something wrong. You're in my room. Ow! Damn it! Put your hand down. Ow! You fucking smacked my face.
I'll fuck you up.
Chill. Just chill out, please. I paid a lot of money for that keyboard you're sitting on. Thank you. Ow! Ow! Gotta get your nails cut. Really hurt. Ow, that pretty fucking hurt.
Hi, I'm back. We can continue. My apologies, Sheree.
Hell yeah. I open the door to peek in and see if anyone's dropped or some weird shit.
The screaming redoubles in loudness.